How I Learned to Talk to Rocks is a collection of my travels to sacred spiritual sites around the world. This chapter, Sliding Down the Yak, tells of my adventures in Tibet, high in the Himalayan mountain range, on a pilgrimage to Mount Kailas, one of the most ancient and sacred holy mountains. This reading is by author Pat Crosby. After 5 freezing days crossing the boulder-strewn Tibetan plateau, a once-upon-a-time ocean floor, now 15,000 feet above the current ocean floor, and called the roof of the world, jostling with our caravan of Chinese drivers, jeeps, overloaded supply trucks carrying 2 weeks of supplies for 40-some people, including food, portable kitchen, tents, sleeping bags, oxygen, fuel for cooking, fuel for vehicles, spare truck and jeep parts, boy, sure glad we had plenty of those, Sherpas and guides, we finally reached the sacred mountain, Mount Kailas, high in the Himalayas of western Tibet. 7 days' journey so far out of rather tropical Kathmandu, 11,000 feet rise in altitude. The 5-day holy ritual walk around the summit of the mountain, or the ritual devotional crawl if you are a Tibetan Buddhist, known as the parikrama, or circling the sacred mountain, is a climb from 15,000 to 18,000 feet. The path rises at a 45-degree angle. It is rocky and steep. Pilgrims throw clothes, chunks of their hair, and occasionally their own bodies, overboard on this climb. These rituals represent leaving behind, letting die, some old aspect of oneself that one cannot keep if one intends to reach the summit of spiritual experience. Already weakened and exhausted by the oxygen-starved altitude, the unrelenting bone-penetrating cold, nausea, dizziness and throwing up any attempted food in the last 5 days at the Tibetan Plateau crossing. Yes, we can call this the Tibetan Plateau crossing diet. Lose 20 pounds in 2 weeks. And the boulder-strewn paths, actually ruts over shifting sand dunes, with numerous jeep breakdowns. I hired a yak with driver to ride up the 45-degree incline, although not long, the rise was intense. Yaks are big, furry, warm survival animals of the Himalayas, somewhat a mix of huge, shaggy buffalo, don't tell me what to do donkey, and heavy-duty survival capable camel. The yak clan provides the human clan with fur, yurt covers, that's their round, portable, nomad houses, meat, milk, butter, transportation, and copious excrement for cooking and fuel in the frigid, treeless Tibetan terrain. These miracles of eco-efficiency manage to turn few and far between stray tufts of dried grass scattered among the sand dunes and boulders, amazingly, into all of the above. And yaks provide essential milk and butter for the famous butter tea of the bitter, cold, wind-chilled Himalayas. Famously drunk by the Dalai Lama, served in monasteries, and the daily cultural survival beverage, tourists find it to be an acquired taste. I found it to be like bone-heating substantial soup broth, and grew to love it. Back to yak transportation. My translator attendant negotiated the deal. He could speak 5 human languages, Mandarin, Tibetan, Nepalese, Hindi, and something else. But I'm not sure if he was yak fluent. Anyway, what a deal it was. A fortune in local currency. Not so much in our money. I got hoisted under the furry animal's warm back. Oh, did I mention there was no saddle, bareback, nothing to hang on to. I clung to the shaggy mane as best I could, gripping, as though my life depended on it. I was slumped prone along the beast's spine. Giddy up, well, not exactly, more like plod, plod, hump, bump, Blood. Blood. Oh, no. I began to slide backwards. Slowly. Insurmountably. Definitely. Half inch by half inch. Gradually losing my grip. Trying denial first. Slip. Slip. Inch by inch. Gripping the hair of the beast harder, intensifying my will grip. Grip. Slip. Slip. Inches by inches, going backward. Beast going forward. The yak driver was nonchalantly talking to his fellow yak driver, both oblivious to we passengers sliding off the rump of their beasts. Slowly, immeasurably. Definitely, inch by inch, no grip to cinch. Finally, a true spiritual experience. Surrender! I had to surrender that I was losing my grip, unceremoniously slipping backwards over the rump of the beast. No dignity. Who cared? No one. Just me and my soul, giving up any pretense that anything was under my control. Inch by inch. Slip by slip, over the tail, trying to grab the tail now. Animal beast could care less. Plod, plod, hump, bump, forward, upward, me, backward, backsliding, rump, hump, humpty dumpty over the edge. Losing the tail, falling to the ground. Holy ground it was. I watched the rump slowly plod away from me. Plod, plod, up the sacred mountain path, leaving me to look at the strewn belongings of the recently or sometime to be departed. Death has no meaning here on Kailas. The most pious consider it the most auspicious place to lose one's body. Just go over the edge, lose your grip, drip, drip. Everyday concerns fall away, down the mountainside into the sea of garbage, of cast-off belongings. All this so the soul can fly free, unencumbered, in the arms of grace, Lord Shiva, Mount Kailas, home of the gods, center of the universe, the most holy place. Creep, creep, hands and knees, inch by inch, get a grip, creep, creep, huffing, puffing, panting, inch by inch, creep, creep, up the stony path, ascending inch by inch. I put my face down in exhaustion on the cold ice, inch by inch. Get a grip, creep, creep, up the path. The sacred mountain. What will greet me at the top? Will I get to the top? Inch by inch. Creep, creep, hands and knees. Pant, pant. Heard one of our party, portly Indian man from tropical Mumbai, had a heart attack. And Sherpa porters carried all of his heart attack heavy weight backward, retracing the path back to the starting place. Maybe another lifetime before he can continue up the sacred mountain. Head hanging down. No energy to look up inch by inch. Hands and knees. Creep, creep, huff, With extreme effort, I raised my head ever so slightly. What? The top? Oh, pilgrims joyfully singing, incense circling in arete, the ancient ceremony, waving of candles in celebration and love, celebration of the light, and achieving communion with the supreme. In dazement, I see our tour guru sitting on a boulder, his immaculate orange sannyasi monk robes, pristine, as though they just had come from the dry cleaners, neat and pressed. He sat on the rock, like a beacon of, yes, you can, big smile, tender smile, loving eyes. My energy came flooding in. I arose, planted my earth legs firmly on top of my earth feet, upright at last, hands waved in celebration. Joy, I can stand at the top. Having attained the summit of the sacred mountain, prasad, blessed sweets for everyone, how divine, God's own celebration party. Summiting was a grand adventure. What will the descent hold? Will it be anticlimactic? You can find more at the author's blog, lightgrid.blogspot.com. That's lightgrid.blogspot.com. Thank you for listening. This is Pat Crosby, the author and spiritual traveler. Thank you.